In the acquisition wizard, you will have all these options here, which I will go over. So you have an option to acquire page from Flatbed, acquire page from Document Feeder. Then you also have the paper size you want to choose from. As you can see here, you may have all these options or much less. This is all dependent on your scanner. Then you have mode. You can either select black and white, grayscale, or color. You also have an option to choose resolution. The lower value you'll pick in here, the faster your scanning process will be. You also have an option to select duplex scanning. What this will do is scan both fronts and back sides of your pages. Now please note, if this option is grayed out, this means your scanner does not support this option here. You have also options to select the brightness, the contrast, and most importantly, advanced device options. This is to open up your scanner's properties. Now once you're in here, you may get this page, or you may get a completely different window to me. This is entirely dependent on your scanner. And this reflects perfectly your scanner's options and potential that it has. Lastly, what we're going to talk about here is batch image processing. So these are options and filters you're going to be applying during the scanning process. So you have an option to rotate. You can select automatically rotate or specific rotating angle. Autodesk U, what this will do is it will slightly fix and correct misaligned pages. Let's say your scanner misaligned one page, it will automatically correct that so it's straight up. Then you have another option, remove black margins, remove punch holes, remove black blank pages, apply the negative effect, and lastly, automatic color detection. What this will do is it will detect whether your page is in black and white, grayscale, or color, and it will apply the best bits per pixel encoding method so that your page has the best quality for the lowest possible file size. Once you have selected the options you want in here, click apply. Lastly, you have these three options down here, which I will not go over, as they are purely based on preference and you do not need to, you can choose them if you wish to do so. Now let's click acquire to acquire our pages. Aside from scanning your pages, you can also choose to import them directly into Paperscan using the import method. Now before we get into this, you must note that in settings there are options you can choose from before importing your pages. These options can be found in settings, batch acquisition, import filters. As you can see, all these options we have already talked about, but they can be found in the settings for importing your files. Also, you can find other options in import in the import tab in settings. You can enable ICM if that's something you do use, and you can also choose your resolution that you want to import your pages in. Now to import your pages, click on import, click on the file you want to select, or you can even select multiple files if you so choose. However, we are going to select only one of them and open. As you can see, my pages have been imported. You can also use the click and drag method if you have no pages imported into Paperscan previously. Simply click your file from your desktop or from wherever and drag it into Paperscan, and it will import your page.